Hello guys, and welcome to this video to talk about one of the current important topics in dentistry, which is artificial intelligence. So first, let's understand the concept of AI, which would be basically the ability of the machines to perform tasks that usually require the human intelligence. There are several classifications. We are going to talk about the main one, but then probably you guys realize that we are talking about weak AI, okay? Which is basically the AI for single tasks or specific tasks, such as moving an object or detecting alterations, specific alterations on the radiographs. So this would be weak AI, and that's the one used in dental research. Strong AI, on the other hand, is not currently being used in dental research because there are still several ethical issues, right? So we need to be careful about that. So that's why we are going to talk about weak AI on this video. So let's talk about the methods. We have machine learning, which further developed to deep learning. Those are methods that allow for recognition, clustering, and classification of data, right? The machine learning and the deep learning can work with supervised or unsupervised data, so labeled data, for example, and of course, when we work with labeled data, then the method is more accurate and it requires a low complex algorithm. So that's basically the difference. And the deep learning further developed to neural networks. Okay, so the neural networks allow us to extract features from the images, for example, detection of objects and things like that. The thing is that the neural network was also further developed to convolutional neural network, which requires less training data for the software to recognize and detect objects on the images, for example. So usually the AI methods in dentistry, they would need that we feed the software with a lot of data and databases, and this is very important for the software to understand what it needs to be recognized on the images, for example. For this reason, so it's a better method, mainly used in image generation and recognition. So first, let's understand the main general applications of AI in dentistry, and then we are going to comment each of them in more details, okay? So we can have the diagnosis, so the software can actually help us to identify a lesion, for example, based on the data that the software is fed with. Then we have the decision making, so the software will be able to understand that based on these features, the best decision for this treatment is this one, and that's also related to the treatment plan of the patient, so that's also an important tool for the treatment plan. And then we also have the outcome prediction. So the software will recognize these features, and then the software will be able to give us a second opinion about the outcome that we are going to probably have for this case. And finally, the case prognosis, which is also very important. So based on things that are happening, the software will be able to recognize what are the odds that this patient will have a nice prognosis or a worse prognosis, okay? So those are all those applications are the ones that are topics of current dental research. And let's see now the details of each of these applications, okay? So let's see why those methods are useful, and let's start with the detection of alterations. And basically, I'm recommending here to you this reference that you guys have on the screen, which is a literature review covering all these applications. Now let's talk about the detection of dental caries and tooth wear. Even incorrect restorations can be detected by the softwares. We are going to talk about that. Then we have bone loss and fractures, okay, also very important. And then the detection of periapical lesions, okay. Even the odds that we have for each type of lesion, for each differential diagnosis of your differential diagnosis list. So this is also possible for the software to predict with a certain accuracy. So the last one would be pre-malignant and even malignant lesions, so carcinoma cases, for example, OSCC. And of course, all those items that I'm showing to you guys have been shown to have high accuracy with those AI methods. Again, you guys can always check the articles that are being cited by this literature review, but there is also more literature available on the PubMed website, for example, about that. So let's understand how this works. I'm going to show you guys an image now, which is an image of the Hello Pearl software, okay, helping the professional to recognize overhangs. So this is an automated recognition of restorations with overhangs. Of course, in this case, it's obvious that there is an overhang there, But then, of course, the software can recognize the pixels and everything, so it would be something that helps the professional. However, the software is recognizing other alterations. I'm going to give you another example, which is basically the bone loss that is being automatically measured on the image that you guys are seeing on the right side of the screen, right? So pretty much a promising aspect. So we should be always updated regarding this type of research using AI for dentistry, right? So now let's understand the second application, which is tissue segmentation and location of anatomical structures. And basically we have articles about the segmentation of the tooth structure, which is very useful. Sometimes we want to segment the tooth to plan a surgery, even the extraction of this tooth with the future implant placement, for example. Then the segmentation and even the volumetric measurements of the pulp chamber. That's amazing. That's something that can be very important. Then the location of anatomical structures, the entire limits of the maxillary sinus, for example, or the bone of the patient, the alveolar bone, which is very important for perio, for example, and even the entire location of the mandibular canal, where we have the inferior alveolar nerve, as you guys know. Then we have the role of the AI on the treatment planning, and here we have a lot of interesting stuff. The AI software can help identifying the need of orthodontic treatment and even the need of extractions for the orthodontic treatment. Okay, so those two features are already identified by research using AI. So you should consider this as well. And even for surgical planning, okay? So for image-guided surgery, the planning of the surgical procedure can also be aided by certain AI methods. And then the restoration design. And here, this is a topic that is very interesting because we can actually use a software like this, for example, that you guys are seeing on the screen. That's the SmileCloud software, okay? In this case, is basically one of the cases of my book. So you guys are seeing the reference of my book. Basically, the software is helping the professional to choose the library of teeth in order for the professional to choose the best tooth shapes for this rehabilitation. So these tooth shapes can also be exported to the 3D format. And then the final digital design of the restoration would also take into consideration the shapes of the chosen library. Okay, so that's why this is very important. And also something that would save time of the professional. And then we have the fourth important usefulness of AI identified by research nowadays, which is the outcome prediction, okay? So we have the debonding of restorations, so this can be predicted in some cases based on some features that would be identified by the AI software, and even the facial appearance that is predicted for the patient to have after the rehabilitation that was decided during the treatment plan. So those are very promising methods that could help the professional, the dental professional, to do the rehabilitation of the patients. And also one thing that I saw on IDS, and I'd like to comment here, is the application for digital dentistry, which is the automated alignment of DICOM files from CBCT, STL files from intraoral scans, and even OBJ files from facial scans. So before, those files should be aligned by finding common points between those files, so common anatomical landmarks that are being shown on all of them, all right? And this, of course, was usually done manually, but now we can do this using an AI, so the procedure is entirely automated, and that's something very promising to save time for the professional to use digital dentistry and the CAD-CAM digital workflow to perform the oral rehabilitation of this patient. So if you guys like this video, please hit the like button, subscribe to our channel, and stay tuned for the next videos.